It's been a very, very long time since I played a game that's actually as bad as the game Perish. And I've recently been picking up a lot of different games on Steam. I've been looking into so many different video games because I'm personally sick and tired of waiting for AAA releases. They take forever, there's constant delays. And on Steam, even though games are not always of the best quality, there's a load of different developers and stuff, there are just so many more games that are coming out. And Perish is one that I've had my eye on for a good few months. I added it to my wish list and I decided to pick it up. This game is going to set you back £15, but it's not even worth a fiver. I think I would honestly, like, I'm trying to be nice about it, but I think I would rather go and stick a £10 note down the drain than purchase this game. And that's why I'm doing this video and saying, do not buy Perish. It's nothing to do with performance either. The game actually runs quite smooth. It's just about the fact that they've spent a very, very long time developing this game and they've not put, like, basically any effort into the game whatsoever. You start off with this, like, bare-bones four-minute tutorial. It gets you to grips with how the game works. Fair enough. Then you go through and all you've got, like, in this main hub is a shop and a portal. The shop is to buy different weapons, different rings, and things like that, and then the portal is to start your mission. But every single time you start, it's in the exact same area that has, like, three different objective types that it can spawn. You're either going to have to go around and light four things, you're going to have to take down this champion, and I can't even remember the other objective there is. But that's not really the problem with it either. As soon as you get a ranged weapon, you can probably do it with the starting melee weapon as well. All you've got to do is go and stand on the starting platform in the middle of the room, and the enemies cannot hit you. And I mean, no matter what they do, whether they're kicking you, if they're trying to hit you with their spears, they cannot attack you. And what makes that really bad, because that normally wouldn't be a huge problem, but these enemies are infinite spawns. So you could essentially stand there for about half an hour, gathering the currency in the game, and then just lead through the portal and go and buy everything in the shop. But if you're playing the game legit, these enemies are spawning in very limited numbers. You only ever have a maximum, like if you're playing solo, you have a maximum of three enemies on the screen at the same time. Unless there's like a boss, then you'll get three adds and the boss. And these enemies can spawn anywhere around you, behind you, in front of you, to the side of you. Some of them pretty much spawn inside you. So you go around, you do the objective, you grab a card at the end of it, which is still in the middle of combat, by the way. It just goes into slow motion. You pick a card and it says you deal massive damage when you kick an enemy. So you can go around and one-tap kick everything. Or you take a card that deals poisonous damage when you land an attack. And it's a one-attack kill to every enemy. Like, every add. Then you go through to the second area. And after you've, like, gone to the first sort of safe space after the first objective, you'll get a new weapon unlock for the first time. You can interact with this health pool and you can get an extra bar of health. Then you can refill your consumables. But your consumable doesn't actually work in this game. It's set to Y on an Xbox controller. It's set to the Y button. And it doesn't matter if you hold it or you press it. It doesn't work. And I know that my Y button works because during the tutorial, it teaches you how to use consumables. And it worked. But throughout the entire game, the consumables don't actually work. And I've tried that the moment I've entered the arena for the first objective. I've tried that in the second arena after making sure that I've definitely refilled my consumables. It doesn't do anything. But not only that, a lot of the stuff that you can purchase in the shop doesn't work how it should. Like when it comes to the rings, I bought a health ring and that did give me the extra bar of health. But then I bought a ring called Prosperity, which is supposed to give you an extra 40% currency and it gives you nothing. Because before getting the ring, I was killing enemies and getting a minimum of 6 currency, and that currency never went any higher for the minimum amount after I had purchased that ring and equipped it. But not only that, when you buy the gun, I can't even remember the name of it. Nothing in this game is memorable. There's a lot of lore, but there's nothing to it. But when I did pick up the gun, you get this special ability where you can fire the entire mag or chamber or whatever in quick succession, which is quite cool, but you don't need it. It's very overkill. Or you get this other thing where you get explosive headshots. So if you jump onto the platform in the middle of the first arena and you've got the explosive headshot one, because you can use that platform to unlock the special abilities in the first place, and then you stand there, you've got three enemies that spawn in and they're standing right next to each other, and you pop one in the head, the explosive headshot kills all three. So you can just farm and farm and farm from the beginning, infinite spawns, and the enemies can't touch you. Like, how have you not picked that stuff up in testing before you've released this game? Because this isn't a Steam Early Access title. This is a full release. Whether it's £15 or £150, it doesn't matter. They are selling this as a fully released video game. And it's not a full release in any way, shape, or form. They've already put out a bug fix to stop progression blockers and stuff, because those were a thing in co-op. And I'm not going to bother asking my friends to pick this game up to play with me, because the game is shit. Nothing changes. There's a very small amount of objectives. There are loads of different cheese spots where the enemies can't hit you at all. The secrets and the codex entries and, like, basically the lore is just a waste of time. There's a limited amount of weapons you have to progress through the game in order to unlock them. They don't just randomly drop or anything like that. And if you die, you just lose like 2/3 of the currency you've gathered in that run. So if you get like 700, you're going to leave with about 230 or something like that. They don't take all of your currency away, and I get it's a roguelite, but there needed to be way more than what there is. And I don't care about the price. It doesn't matter that it's only £15. People can afford to waste £15. The amount of videos I do for games and people say, yeah, but it's only $30. It doesn't matter. Oh, it's only $50. The only reason you wouldn't be able to afford to waste this money is if you're a jobless bum. Or, like, people just get stupid with it. But it's not the fact that it's only £15. It's the fact that they're charging you and having the nerve to charge you any money at all for a product that is this poorly, like, executed. Because the game runs smooth. If they had put more effort into it, it would be a decent game. But they've just half-assed absolutely everything. There are like two different enemy models that you get in the first arena. There's even this like objective. That's one of the other objectives in the first one. The walls come up around this middle platform and you have to survive an ambush. But I got objective completed for surviving the ambush when there were about four or five enemies left. Because that's the only time more than three enemies will spawn in, is when you get ambushed. But there were loads of enemies left and I got objective complete, which makes no sense. And there's another card in the game that you can get, which is complete overkill. Just land a single attack on an enemy and it sets them on fire. So you've got poison and fire that's an insta-kill. You've got this overkill special ability for your gun, which fires like six rounds in one shot. It's just so stupid. When you get through to the second arena, the enemies don't get any better. They don't get really any different. You just have a ranged enemy spawn in as well, instead of changing up everything completely, or like at least changing some of the melee, like monsters, creatures, enemies, whatever. There's just nothing to this game whatsoever. I've played games that are 10 times, 15 times better than this that are a third of the price. I've played lots of games that are so much better in quality. This game just doesn't have any of it. Like, I appreciate they've put the time into working on this game and actually creating a game, because it's not easy doing game development, learning coding, being an artist, all that sort of stuff. That cannot be easy. But at the same time, if you're going to do your job, do it properly. Whether you've got QA testers or whatever, at least get the people that have created the game to sit down and play it and see what they need to work on. Like, in-house test some of your stuff, because you can literally stand anywhere that's got a bit of height to it in this game and you are untouchable. The enemies don't know what to do, and there's no invisible barriers on some of the objects in the rooms where there should be. In fact, there's a platform that's quite high up where the enemies cannot attack you, that has a secret codex entry placed there. So they're encouraging people to go there and figure out that you can cheese all the enemies from standing on something high up. This game does not deserve £15. It doesn't deserve any of your money. They need to put it into early access if possible, or pull it from the store and do more work to it, because this is not it. This is 100% not worthy of being a full release. And I don't care what anyone says, this is not a full release title. There are so many fundamental issues with this game. So that for me was £15 or $20 down the drain. It's a game I will not return to unless there are major overhauls to a lot of the systems in there. And yeah, the developers just need to do better. That's all it is, because the game would be fun if the fundamental features worked properly. Because to get the ring that cost that gives you 40% extra currency, it cost me 3,000. Like, granted, the majority of it I built by just standing in the middle of the room where the enemies can't attack me. But I saved up 3,000 currency, thinking, oh yeah, I can get through the currency faster, and it makes no difference whatsoever. So they need to rework, overhaul, and fix most of the stuff in this game. And then it might be worth taking a look if they drop the price to a fiver and put it into early access. Charge $8 for it. This is not a $20 game. And sort out the enemy spawns. Stop it being infinite spawns so that people can't just farm whenever they want to, especially in the first arena. And I don't think as you progress through, the enemies drop more the harder they get. I don't think that's a thing in this game. But that's my video for the game Perish, and I strongly recommend that you do not buy this one. But that's going to do it for this video. Check out this video if you want to see other content on the channel. I will see you in the next one. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you for watching.